Welcome back. On this video, we will be going to see how we can enable the multi-factor authentication to secure the IAM user account. Whenever the user will be signed in to the AWS console, then he has to enter the MFA code to get access into the AWS account. First, we have to go in IAM service to get the MFA settings. Click on it and we will be there in IAM dashboard. Here we can see that under security recommendations that it shows MFA must required to improve security for this user account. Now we will go to click on add MFA option here and we are in new tab. Here you can see that AWS IAM credential, this is the basic password which need to change on a regular basis. Right now we'll scroll down to get the MFA. To increase the security, AWS recommends to enable the MFA to protect the AWS resources. AWS Multi-Factor Authentication is required two or more forms of authentication to protect AWS resources. This is an additional security feature available through Amazon Identity and Access Management, that is IAM, that strengthens username and password credentials. As you can see that it is not yet assigned to any devices, so we are going to do this now. Click on assign MFA device here. You can choose the type of MFA device to assign. Virtual MFA device. It is required to install the Authenticator application on our mobile device or computer. Example, say you know that Google Authenticator. And U2F security key. It is required YubiKey or any other compliant U2F device. Other hardware MFA device, it is required Gemalto token. But out of these three, I would like to go with virtual MFA device, as Google Authenticator is available in Play Store and I have already installed it on my phone, which can be installed and operate easily. So select the first one and go for continue. Here we can see the QR code which need to be scanned from the mobile device on which Google Authenticator application has installed. So let's go for it. Click on QR code to scan this from the phone. Yes, let me open it on my phone and there I got it. After scanned, we will get the code. We do need to enter the first MFA code as shown in Authenticator app. Here I got 809533. We'll enter the same and we'll wait to get the second MFA code. Then again enter the same which you can see here, that is 253543. Then we'll go for the next step to click on assign MFA, and there we are guys, we have successfully assigned virtual MFA. Now we will log out from this session and log in back with the MFA code. Here on this window, we have to enter the account name and user credentials. This is the primary step. After pass this, we will get the another windows to enter the MFA code. Here again, we have to open the Authenticator app to get the code, and that code we have to use here to get access into the AWS console. There we are guys, successfully logged into the AWS console with the help of MFA code. See, the account name is Gyani and the alias name is Techntechie Lab, which got access successfully in Mumbai region. And when we click on IAM, then it will switch to global. Okay guys, here you can see that we have passed all the three security recommendations from AWS. Now we will go to see the billing dashboard for this user, as this user is in admin group, so he can access and monitor the billing dashboard. Let's go for it. This user needs a permission, as it shows that this user do not have permission to access billing information for this account and need to contact the administrator. What we have to do here, so this user will get access into the billing dashboard. We'll see this on my next video. Till then, have a great day and bye bye.